Okay. So for every because of this because since we are based in different time zones, not everybody is able to attend some sessions. Maybe they will miss it, or maybe they have work. So we will provide training recording of the sessions also, so that you do not miss anything overall. Okay, but thanks for sharing. Okay, your highest academic background in which field and the passing year? So you have formal sciences. Now, formal sciences can be physics, chemistry, math, biology, these things. Natural sciences can be applied science or this formal science also, formal science will include the programming. Okay, computer science, applied science, MCA, BCA, these degrees. Natural science will include physics, chemistry, math, bio. Social sciences will geography, history, and civil, these things. Professions, legal, business, management, these things. And humanities can be literature, arts, anything. Pursuing PhD. Okay, who is pursuing PhD? Is it Jayasri? I could not get the name. Jayasri, are you pursuing PhD? Okay, great. Okay, so we have many from 2016 to 19 bracket, and some from 2011 to 15 bracket. I actually also fall in that bracket. So I also graduated in 2013. Okay. So we have some formal science and some natural science. Okay, so formal science, those who are from formal science, can you mention in chat maybe that, okay, Ria, you are saying you can't interact with the screen. You can do you see annotate option? You go to your meeting options. There will be some more or some icon will be there, either more options or annotate. You can click on it. Pencil icon will be there for annotate. You can click on it and then you can mark. Okay, then you mention in the chat. Okay, that will be good. I will. You do not need to go in the participant list. Since others are able to see, you will be also able to see. Do not go into participant list. Go into more options or annotate options. Okay, there is a view. Okay, so go on the view, and it also depends on which app, which tool you are using, like which device you are using. Okay, so the interface will change depending on that. No issue. You can mention here in chat also if you are not able to get the annotate icon. Okay, Anil, you are saying Masters in Computational Science Engineering. So you belong to formal sciences. Okay. Sagar, you are from Applied Geology and Geoinformatics. That's interesting. Geoinformatics is quite an interesting one. 2016, okay. MSc stats you did in 2019. There are many people who either graduated in 2021 or 22 and after, like those who are still a student. So I have something good news for you. You will have some access to a tool that others may not be able to get. We will talk about that also. Currently pursuing seventh semester in BTEC. Okay, great. Computer engineering, MBA in business analytics. Okay, that's great. I mean, you are from analytical background. That's I want to understand that those who are new to data science and those who are not. So that's what I wanted to understand here, not just data science, but in programming overall also. BTEC, ECE, okay, completed PGDM finance. So hi there, I also did PGDM in finance and marketing, say similar background. Global MBA, BTEC, CSE, okay, great, thanks. Many are, I see that many are from this engineering background. They may or may not have programming knowledge of Python or R, but at least you are from that background. No worries. Yeah, thanks for sharing. MBA in HR management. Okay. Biotech. Okay, kind of new to data science and ML. Okay, great. MBA in marketing, currently applying for student visa in USA, pursuing MS in business analytics. Okay, great. US, okay. There are some good programs in Singapore also. Look for that. It's here like the cleanest country. Everything is fine. Just that it's very fast. Everything is fast. Otherwise, if you need a space, go to US. If you need fast space, come to Singapore. In 1 hour, you can go from one corner to another. Sustainable system engineering. Okay, great. Interesting. Interesting variations. I see the diverse group. Okay, that was about academics. But when it comes to professional experience, now here I want to understand which industry or like what is your experience? As a business analyst, if you have any experience, please mark here, and also your total work experience in terms of years. Marketing, Priyanka is from data management, Anil, up to 1 year, Jayashree, 5+ year, okay. Business analyst, okay. Engineering, fresher, sales management, healthcare, software development, data analyst, Kirti Raikar from Fraser, okay. Then up to 1 year, up to 2 years of experience, we see some. Two people with 5+ years of experience, many are freshers. Okay. Entrepreneur, others, there are two people in others. Data management, I believe it's four different ticks. Then software development also. Okay, up to 2 years, again, one in data analyst. Anything more? Again, one fresher. Banking and finance, and one more in data management, and up to 2 years. Okay. Now, you know why I am asking you to do annotation? This is called data visualization. If I read in chat your responses, I won't be able to, like, quickly grasp that, okay, where the numbers are more. So either I could do a survey, but I thought that let's involve into the writing also, messing up the screen. So, okay, I see that, okay, most of the chunk, like here is from freshers or up to 2 years. And then many of you have experience of data management. Business analyst, data analyst, data science. I believe there is only one person, and software development. Okay, so I have a specific question. So those who are into software development, what program you worked on? Which programming language you used or you have been using? Python. So Sahil, you are saying Python. Did you work on what was the scope of your work? Like, were you involved in data visualization using Python, data preparation, or was it into data science, machine learning, and deep learning as well?
It wasn't a machine learning or data. It was more of data analytics using Python, and basically the project changes accordingly. So afterward, it was more on the data engineering side, data engineering, data wrangling kind of project. But from the past 2.5 years, I'm working, my primary language is Python.
Okay, so I believe that most of the time you must be using these libraries, Pandas, NumPy.
On a daily basis, actually on a daily basis.
Okay, great, thanks. Those who mentioned a business analyst, can you please elaborate on your work profile? Like which tool you were using? Did you use any business intelligence tool? Like what was the work like?
Just to point out again on this, I used to work on Tableau and Power BI. Most of the work, most of the dashboarding tool I used was Tableau.
Okay.
And one of the projects I made was on this Power BI. Okay. Apart from that, I use Python libraries to create dashboards.
Okay, good. Thanks. Anybody else who had experience working on Python programming or any BI tool, be it Tableau, Power BI, or like creating dashboards? Those who are saying data analyst, I want to know, get some information from them. Like, okay, Python, Power BI, Python and Tableau. Okay. Yeah, Python is, although it's a dangerous name, but it's a popular, most popular programming language nowadays. The benefit is that it's an application language as well as can be used for UI development. You used Python for your master's thesis for 6 months. Okay, so I believe you have academic exposure to Python. Why I'm asking about professional experience? Okay, someone is writing on the screen and did some internship. Okay, thanks. So why, like, it's I am asking about the professional experience, because in academics we follow certain, like, we have a lot of resources to take a reference from, but in a professional setup we get some challenge that it is out of the ordinary. But there also we take a reference. It's not like that we do not Google. As a data scientist or even a software programmers, software developers, we all use Google. Okay. If someone is saying that they have never used never use references, online references in their work, that person is lying. Okay. So I will, when we work on the coding part, we will also talk about some resources from where you can take a reference. Okay. Thanks for sharing. Those who are fresher, I believe you are targeting for a job, or those who have, like, some of you might be going into some career transition. Some of you may have some a professional work gap or education gap. Especially during COVID time, it has happened a lot. So we will see that how we can, during one of two sessions, actually, we will also look into that how we can, when applying for a job, how we can overcome this negative part, how we can mention it. Jayasri, you are saying you are interested in learning and applying data science, ML, and BI to in life sciences and healthcare research and industry. Actually, it's the applications of BI tools or even like data science is everywhere. So in healthcare also, research and industry. Actually, I know I have worked on some projects actually in healthcare also, where we used SQL language, okay, and Tableau for the data reporting and data analytics, data visualization. So it finds its usage. Data science finds its usage in all industry, irrespective of the industry that you are working in. Everywhere we have data, and everywhere we need people to, like, companies need people to analyze it. I wanted to understand, the image is a little blurred, sorry for that. So these are the ranking of BI tool that has been done by Gartner. I will also add one, maybe here I will add Excel. Okay. Now you tell me, have you used any of these tools for dashboard creation? So have you created dashboard on any of these tools? Or you just give a underline or a round mark? they are very big circles. There are some circles which are not covering any name. Okay. So we see most of you. Okay, Microsoft is Power BI. Okay. Microsoft is Power BI. The option that you see here, Microsoft, it's Power BI. So those who have worked on Power BI, please circle over there or give a tick mark over there. So Power BI is in for past 3 years, it's in it's on the rank one in all BI tools. Okay, so most of you, I think, have worked on, like those who responded, but Tableau, I see. Power BI also 5 people, I think 5 or 6. And then 3 people have worked on Excel. I see 1 mark on SAS. So there are many SAS, SAS Studio, SAS Enterprise Miner. I believe you have worked on one of these. And okay, 1 more in Excel and Tableau also. Okay, great. Okay. Thanks for sharing. So here I just wanted to understand on these tools especially, because we have these tools in our projects. So if you want to learn Power BI, there is a project for that. If you want to learn Tableau, there is a project for that also. And in Excel also, we have a project to explore the concepts of these tools and to create dashboards on them and how to even communicate those findings, those insights. Okay, next question, actually, I have already asked about the programming languages. So I think you have already mentioned that you have worked on Python, and those who are in software development, you may have worked on maybe Java or something else. But if you have worked on any other language, you can point it out here. Okay, we have C, PHP, SQL, okay. R also, we have 2C, SQL 2, okay. Okay. I mean, even if you have some intermediate knowledge of these tools, you can, these languages, you can mark it. C++, PHP, SQL also. Arumi saying she learned C++ in 12th. Actually, I also learned that, but then I forgot. There are a lot of braces, curly brackets out there. In that term, Python is much easier. Okay, thanks for sharing. So those who have some programming knowledge, you must be aware of the logics, okay, or how programming works. So the basic concepts are similar in Python also. Just a couple of, like the syntax will be different, the language will be different a little bit. But suppose there are logics, a true, false, 0 and 1, then the logics are same in Python also. So when we work on Python, we will see the same logic, similar logics, but in a different way and in a much easier way. So when we talk about, when we use Python for application or as well as like to write any program. So basically we will try to create a game. We will, in the training, we will try to create a complex calculator or maybe anything. We will try to create a loop, a concept. So we will learn a couple of things, then through e-learning, through live training sessions, we will explore it even more before going on our advanced projects, which involve machine learning and deep learning things. Okay, thanks. These questions also I have already asked. I understand that maybe you may have academic exposure to machine learning, those who are students or those who have this background. You may have exposure to machine learning as well as some concepts of deep learning. But have you actually worked on in a like, have you used this in a development of a tool, or have you deployed your code in a live environment anywhere? Though, especially those who are into deep, those who are marking deep learning. Okay, someone's saying yes. Are you talking about the deployment? What was the project and where did you deploy it? You can unmute your mic and let us know if the person who said yes, are you referring to deep learning project? And like, what was the project about? Was it your part of your work, or was it part of your academic project? And where did you deploy it? Many are on machine learning. Okay. 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 Good. Okay. Okay. Thanks for sharing here. So actually, we are okay. We have a response from Arka Pravo, and recently completed a project on developing multi-layered CNN to predict COVID-19. What was the month this about this COVID-19? Like, when did you complete it? Because actually we have been running this similar project for last 6-7 months. Someone has copied our project. Privacy data breach is there. Okay, I'm not sure. Okay, did you use Python or R, or what language did you use? So actually one of our project include, okay, you used Python. So one of our project also involves on this like deep learning project image classification. I believe you have also done the image classification part. So we do image classification on this COVID-19 data, a combination of chest X-ray and one more data set is there. And then we try to predict it, and we try to deploy it. So deployment is also there, like end to end. It's not just that we write a program and leave it. Those who have academic exposure to machine learning, you may have written a code in Python, in a notebook, Jupyter notebook or Google Colab, but and you must have left it like that. Like you wrote the code, you ran it, it's working, and you save the file, you close the system. But that doesn't work in professional setup. Once we write the code, we deploy it in a production environment for a practical use. So in this project, there is a project that where we will also learn about the deployment. And that involves deep learning. Okay, thanks for sharing here. Now, have you watched these movies or series? Actually, all of these are movies only. Have you watched this movie? Which movie you have watched? Just give a tick mark. So basically, I have watched Imitation Game, and I have watched Transcendence. So these two I am marking. Okay. Okay. So Imitation Game, many have watched. It's not a very old movie. In last, I believe 3 years only, it was at least 3 or 4 years. So everybody has spent time on this. Moneyball is also a good one. Okay. Transcendence, nobody has asked. Wow. okay. None. It's fine. It's completely fine. Why I'm asking this question? Because in all of these movies, data is involved, like data driven concepts are there. Data analytics or artificial intelligence are a deep learning is involved in all of these movies. So I would suggest to you watch at least, like whenever you get time, watch at least this movie, Moneyball. How they have used data to take, how they have used analytics to take data-driven decisions. So whatever we are going to work on our project, like this is a kind of a real life example of how data analytics works in real life. Yeah. These movies may be a bit confusing, more of AI part, but this is very practical and a good one. Real life examples, how things work, how we use BI tools outside our academic environment. Okay. Everybody, thanks for sharing all this. Now, I will just give a brief about VIP and work and talk about a couple of more information on this, the projects in next 20-25 minutes, and then we'll take up your questions. Okay, so about VIP, I believe you understand, you know about this, that you know that VIP is a training cum internship program. Training and internship, why we are saying it's in training as well as internship when we are focusing mostly on training part, because many of you are students, and we had this this issue with our previous batches, that there were some students, those who wanted to learn but could not get time, or college would not allow them, or those who were like officially they could not get they could not give time, especially during summer time. So they wanted us to they suggested us to have a program, something related to training as well as internship, so that they can get internship certificate. So we have done that, and also we have added our project here, our internal project. So when you are done with the training part, when you learn some concepts or some tools, you learn, you can use those learnings on a special internal data also. I will talk on that later on also. So here you get trained on specific skills through different modes, different training modes, and get training certificates for those skills. So for each, you will get a training certificate. Jayasri, you are annotating something, any question? Then at the end, you also get an internship certificate after you complete it. Now at the end of the internship period. Okay, no problem. And the content for this has been developed by the Sparks Foundation, Microsoft. Like there are some, projects for which the content has been taken from Microsoft, their trainers or their content. Some are from LinkedIn Learning, and some are from Exaltius. This is a tech company in Singapore. Okay, I get a question. Will we get training on all data science tools, and how many tools? Okay, now, like I mentioned, that I will just give a brief introduction of everything, and then I will take up the questions. Most of your questions that you are having, I will be I will cover during this discussion only. Okay. Now, when we're talking about the training, so we will have different modes of training. E-learning, there will be some resources, documents, and videos from our training partners. There are some public videos also, and there are some unlisted or private videos. Okay. Privately shared videos are there. So like you cannot search for those videos on YouTube. But when we give you the link, you will be able to watch on YouTube. So on YouTube, there are something called unlisted videos, which you cannot search, but you can access through links. So those videos are from Microsoft actually. And as a training partner, we have acquired those links from them, and you will have access to it as a part of this program. Then there are some courses from LinkedIn Learning, which we have curated or listed for you. From TSF also, we will have some trainings from TSF as well as some open source platforms. We have taken some e-learning resources. We will have training, live training sessions also. Usually, on an average, we try to spend 3 to 4 hours at least on the training, apart from your e-learning resources, apart from your the videos that you are watching through e-learning. Okay. The industry practitioners will be from India, Singapore, Malaysia in this batch for the training. And apart from this, we will have some workshops for job readiness. So this is useful for those who are freshers or those who are looking for a job, those who have career gaps, or how to create a proper resume. These things also we will see into when we go for our job readiness sessions. Then there will be DAV clinics. So on an average, DAV clinic will be for 1 hour on each on every alternate day. Okay, to resolve your issues, any question that you may have, any technical queries you may have. However, before that, we suggest you ask your questions on WhatsApp group so that there will be others to answer it, because we want you to be interactive among one another and help one another. Those who want to apply for a LOR, letter of recommendation, please be proactive in WhatsApp group and help others with their questions. So it happens that you are very attentive, you read all details in the document, or you follow the instructions, and then there will be someone who kind of do not pay that much attention. Even if your information is there in the document, the person will not pay attention or ask in the WhatsApp group. So if you know, you can answer it. So something similar to that, generic as well as technical questions you can answer. There are some interns from previous batches in the WhatsApp group, and they will also help you with any query that you may have. If your queries are not resolved here, then definitely it will be taken care of in the doubt clearance sessions. If you have no questions for a doubt clinic, then maybe we will conduct a training session for any tool. So usually what will happen, suppose 2 hour doubt session is there. So 15-20 minutes will go on the doubts, and then the rest will go on the training. Maybe on one day we will take up Excel, on one day we will take up Power BI's and Tableau, something like this. Now coming on the projects, because many of you have questions, may have questions on the projects, what projects are there, how many to do, when to do these things. Now these are the projects, or these are the tools that we are focusing on. So you see that how many we have here. We have 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. These major 9 projects are focusing on 9 different skills or tools. Okay. Here we have Excel, so data visualization on Excel, Power BI, Tableau. Then we would have working on SQL language, but this is Transact SQL that we are using Microsoft data for this, Microsoft server for this, and they use TSQL, so we are teaching that. Essentials of Python programming is for beginners. Those who are absolute beginners in Python, go for this project. We will have detailed training on this also. And then some data manipulation, some more practice here before going on some advanced projects. Statistical analysis or machine learning or for this. Now, what projects you want to do? See, all these projects are open for everybody. If you can give more time, suppose you are not working and you are a student, or suppose you are at home And if you can give 4-5 hours every day, so trust me, you can give on an average 4 hours on each project, and you will be able to complete all. Within a week, you will be able to complete. But I do not encourage that. You go through the resources at least. So suppose in my predictive analytics here, we will use 2 or 3 methods. But that doesn't mean that in machine learning, there are 2-3 methods only. There are various methods or algorithms, machine learning algorithms are there. Learn all through the training, through the resources, but look into what is suitable for the data provided and then work on it. So we will go through the training also, that how to decide which method to use. Now you see that many of you are not from technical background, not from programming background. And maybe you are in a different job profile, and you want to go into data and data science side. Before you go into data science, I would suggest you take up the easy task or the easy projects, which are less technical and more business oriented. For example, data analytics and visualization. Now, visualization is everywhere. Be the visualization on Python, Power BI, Excel, or Tableau. Visualization is in all companies. So you try to go through Microsoft Excel at least. Work on Microsoft Excel project if you are completely beginner to visualization. Microsoft Excel is the mother of analytical tool. It's a very underappreciated, underrated tool, but it can do many things. It's very powerful. It's just that we have a mentality that, okay, Power BI and Tableau are very popular, very powerful. But to be frank, and you have also realized that in all companies, you go into entry-level jobs and everywhere Excel is being used, Excel or Google spreadsheets. So learn about this through the training and complete the project of Excel. Those who already know Excel, no need to work on it. Okay, you move ahead with the second or third project that you want to work on. There's no set rule that okay, you have to do these many projects. What all you have to complete? It's completely on your choice. But go through this sequence. First, decide you want to work on Excel or not. If not, then only move to Power BI. Then only move to Tableau. Why? Because our training will also be into this sequence. So if tomorrow you start working on predictive analytics and you ask me to provide training for this, I won't be able to do that. Because I want others also to go through this Python basics before I conduct a training for predictive analytics for machine learning. And this for these three projects, the timeline usually comes in the second week, end of second week. We provide live training, and this involves an external trainer. So we call external trainer to give a training on these three projects into 2 or 3 sessions. And then one session will be focused on the doubt clearance and deployment of this project. Okay. Before that, we try to finish these projects, whatever you are interested into. So maybe day after tomorrow, we will have a training on Microsoft Excel. After that, we can have a training on a brief discussion on Power BI. Now, the Power BI project, those who want to go into data analytics, I would suggest you go for Power BI also. If you ask me Power BI versus Tableau, I would suggest go with Power BI. 2 reasons. First, it's free. Power BI desktop is free. Second, it is the most popular or the powerful BI tool. We saw that in the rating also previously on the chart. Power BI is a Microsoft product, and companies, when they use Microsoft products, it's easier for them to integrate Power BI in their IT infrastructure, rather than taking a Tableau or some other external tool. And if you search for any job, like a business analytical tool, The job description will not specifically say, or maybe very less, 99.9% of the job descriptions will say, you should know a BI tool such as Power BI or Tableau. They will give like such as, because learning the concepts, the basic concepts are same on any tool. Learning where to click, it just differs. So if you know working on Power BI or if you know working on Tableau, then you can easily learn the other tool. Just the interface is different using iPhone and using an Android phone. The interface is different. Okay. But Power BI is kind of, you can say, Android, wide, free, like cheaper, popularly used. And also, why I am giving emphasis here, because this has been entirely developed by Microsoft, the content of the training. So here for Power BI, we will provide you the introduction session will be just for 1 hour. For Excel, it will be about 3 to 4 hours. Okay, similarly for Tableau, 3 to 4 hours. But for Power BI, only 1 hour intro session will be there to give you a brief or to help you initiate the project. And then there will be a lab manual in 3 parts, which you have to follow, which mention a step-by-step process, what to do, where to select, and why we are doing it. Suppose a bar chart needs to be created. So where to click to create a bar chart and why we are using bar chart here. So all detailed explanation is there, and the content has been developed by Microsoft. So we are not making any changes to the content. As a partner network member of Microsoft, we are delivering the training as it is. So we are also not authorized to make the changes. If you go for a live training for this, and in the session, if you follow the steps, it will take about maybe 8 to 9 hours. And since many of you are students, some of you are also working, we want to give you flexibility that whenever you are free, you work on the tool, you follow the document. And if you follow it, it will take only maybe 6 hours at max to complete it. Okay. Tableau, we will also go through the training part here. 3 to 4 hours, we will create a dashboard, we will create a storyboard, and then you can start working on the project. Data reporting and analysis with TSQL. So here also a Microsoft maintained data we will use, and we will try to explore SQL. This is for data reporting. Now, those who want to go into business analysis, I would suggest you learn Excel, you learn Power BI or Tableau, prefer Power BI, and go on the basics of Python at least at initial level. So those who have zero experience in data science, data analysis, work on these first, Excel, Power BI, and essentials of Python programming, learn these things. Once done, go for data manipulation here and SQL. Now, if you cover these things, you open the job description on Naukri.com, Times Job, or on LinkedIn, and you see what skills they are asking for. No one will ask for everything. Like, you should know Excel, Power BI, Tableau, SQL, Python, and these things. That would be a very insane job description. So if you want to go into business analytical side, go for these tools, these two, and essentials of Python, finish this, then this and this. Those who already know working on Power BI, Tableau, and Excel, if you are good in creating dashboards, then you can skip these things, okay? You can directly go on what you want to learn. Python you want to learn, go with essentials, data manipulation, and then work on. Here we will do A-B testing. Here we will do A-B testing. Here we will do some random forest or regression analysis. We will also try to do customer churn. Here we will use image classification, TensorFlow we will use, and we will deploy it. Okay. So these are the available projects for everybody. Now, this project, the last one, 10th project, is internal project for us. Okay. It is not guided. So here we are providing training materials will be there, but this is completely unguided. So you get trained on, okay, see how, what quality you can deliver. And then we will share with you, you ask for this project and we will share with you the data. For this, there will be a separate confidentially agreement because this is internal data. And here we will try to analyze some records. So there will be about more than 100,000 records, and you will try to analyze the candidates' demographic as well as their academics, their skill sets, job data. Basically, this is a job data. So we will try to understand that. So you will take this as a business problem, and from scratch you will start. Either you will use some exploratory analysis using Tableau or Power BI, or you will use your deep learning concepts or machine learning concepts. But this will be completely unguided. So I would not suggest that you should go on this first. Okay, learn these tools. Focus on this part. Focus on the learning. Once you are confident and you get time, then you go for this project. You can ask us, and we will share the data separately to individuals. And so these will be the projects, and the deadline will be 24th. 24th of November will be the deadline. So see that how many projects you are able to complete and submit by 24th. Now, what are the projects or the project details? We will share tomorrow. You will get an email with the project list. And also in the evening, we will discuss about the projects. So tomorrow we will meet and we will discuss about the projects. I will take a couple of more minutes to just mention what to expect next. Okay, orientation email you have already received. We have we are done with that. Invitation to join WhatsApp group. Okay, so you will get an email to join in WhatsApp group of VIP. Can I not extend beyond 24th? What does that mean? Like what you are referring to exactly about the project submission? Is machine learning a part of Python? Yes. So all the programming projects are based on Python. If you want to work on R, then you can take the predictive analytics. Machine learning, you can take on R. But the external trainer that who will come gives training on Python. And also, we also kept Python because kind of it's most popular, yeah, widely used. More demand is there. In the job market, there is more demand for Python. Now, Aga Prabhu, you are asking about the extension of projects or what? See, okay, I will answer, I believe, what you are asking. So now, everybody, see here. Suppose you decide that, okay, you want to learn Excel, Power BI, Tableau, and also you want to learn Python. These things you want to learn. But by 24th, you are able to submit only these. You are able to work on only these. And you want to learn these as well. So you can apply for the extension of the internship. Do not apply for the deadline extension, okay? Let's try to follow the deadline extension. And promise yourself that yes, by deadline, you will submit these projects. So complete at least two projects to be eligible for the extension. Once you apply for the extension can be given maximum for 1 month. Like the next deadline will be 24th of December. So at the end of November, if you have submitted these three projects, you will get 3 training certificates for each of these projects. Okay. And next month in December, you submit these 2 projects. So at the end of December, you will get 2 more training certificates for these 2. And at the end of December, you will get 1 internship certificate. So internship certificate will come always at the end. Now suppose, I believe this point is clear in the case of extension. Now suppose someone wants to learn only SQL. So suppose you want to work on only SQL, you learned it, you worked on it, and now you are done. You don't want to you don't want extension, you want to complete the internship in November end only. So at the end of November, you will get 1 training certificate plus 1 internship certificate. If you complete 2 projects in November, you will get 2 training certificates plus 1 internship certificate if you are not applying for extension. So I believe that will help you guys. Okay, there is a question. Is machine learning part of Python? Yes, so all Python, everywhere we are using Python. Is a statistical analysis and hypothesis testing a programming exercise? Yes, so we will use Python there also. So using Python only, we will do that. Will we be working on NN as part of MLDL? So yeah, CNN is there. I believe NN is also there, but CNN is definitely there. Actually, on deep learning, I am not taking the training. But CNN is there. External trainer will be there to give you, to guide you on that. What is the criteria to get an LOR? Okay, so for LOR, there are 2 things. Be proactive in helping others. Second thing, deliver quality in your work. And one more, that do not complete the task just for the sake of getting a certificate. But that's where we will see how much quality you are delivering. Take this internship seriously, because we have hired some previous interns in our part-time and full-time roles. Okay, and we plan to do this with each batch. Like we tried, not we, actually the company, not me, the company NAI, it goes through the, like, your project submissions and see your quality of work, how serious you are, how attentive you are. Okay, if you ask questions, in email we have mentioned something. For example, a lot of times we get this question that every time there will be a training, people will ask, where is the meeting link? And we always mention, like at the beginning, we mentioned that, okay, meeting link is in the description of WhatsApp group. But still we get 2-3 questions, 2-3 people asking that. Although it's a very little query, very small query, but it shows that maybe you were not paying attention. So show your professionalism, deliver quality in your work, okay? And more than targeting for the job, be proactive in helping others. And more than targeting for the job, you focus on the learning part. Once you focus on the learning, your quality will be better. And that will show up in your work also. So for LOR, those things will be used. And also there will be a minimum number of tasks, like at least try to do 2-3 tasks to get an LOR. Will we get recorded meeting link as I joined late? I missed first half. Okay. Hi, Lakshmi. Yeah, you joined late. So this meeting is being recorded and it will be updated. Don't worry. You can go to YouTube, search for NAAI. You will find a channel, NAAI. Not many videos are there, just that these recordings are there. Okay. So after the session, within 1 or 2 hours, it will be uploaded over there. Are we using satellite data in image classification? So in image classification, we are using COVID chest X-ray data and some CT scan data. Okay. We are also using. We will keep changing some of the projects, some of the data sets that we will try to change the difficulty levels also, because in the past batches we have experienced that not many people work on this project. This is advanced, and those who are beginners, it is a bit difficult for them. So we understand that we do not force it to everybody to work on it, because those who are beginner, trust me, I also come from a non-IT background, and when I was a beginner, I took a lot of time to learn machine learning. Even deep learning is not my very strong suit. Now also. Okay, then. Milano, you won't be available for live training for a couple of weeks. So, not a problem. A couple of days in this week. So in this week, we will focus on mostly Excel, Power BI, and I believe Tableau we will be also able to cover. But recording sessions will be there. Videos will be there, uploaded on YouTube. So you can go through it if needed. And if you are good on these tools, then no need to. It won't be a loss for you. If you take 1 month extension and complete all projects properly, will I be able to? See, do not worry about LOR as of now, okay? At first, and also do not avoid to ask these questions in orientation. LOR is good. I understand why LOR is needed and how it can help you. You can always focus on getting an LOR, but focus on the quality. I'm not saying that you work on all projects, but even if you are working on 2-3 projects, show your dedication there, show your expertise, and apply for LOR. You will get it. Like, there is no very hardcore rule that, okay, we are not giving LOR to somebody. It's okay. Professional LOR you need, that will be fine. You will get it, but deliver, but at least submit some projects. Yeah. Okay, Milano, sure, no issue. Anyway, if you come back, then we will have some doubt sessions also. You can ask any question in any doubt session. How much time will be asked to give every day? Okay, the timing is not fixed. You are the king of or queen of your timing, okay? Whenever you are free, work on the projects. But if you are a beginner on any of these tools, so when we are giving training, then please attend the training sessions at least. Okay, do not rely on the recording of the trainings. Why? Because you may face some questions which needs to be solved live, like during the sessions. So video may not be helpful for you. But on an average, every weekend, even if... I won't say every day, but every alternate day, if you are giving 2-3 hours, you should be able to complete 4-5 projects here. See, many projects are very easy. Excel is very easy. Power BI is completely guided. You follow the steps, you will be able to complete. Essentials of Python will be a live training. I will help you with this project, okay? It's just a learning project. It's not a task. It's just a learning content, you can say. And this also. This also contains a step-by-step guidance in there, what to write, where to write, why to write, all those things. You have to just read the notebook or the description and follow accordingly. So whenever you are free, you can work on these things. Couple of things which need some training, like Tableau will need training. Excel, we will start with Excel. Initially, it will take some training. Then you will be able to do this. And these parts, these are some advanced parts. So for this, we will conduct training in the weekends. So please attend the sessions. Yeah. We will let you know about the training timings beforehand. Okay, so what to expect next to this, I mentioned that we have covered. WhatsApp group invitation will be sent via email in next 1 or 2 hours. Or or let me see if I can send it right away. Okay, I'm sharing with everybody in the chat the WhatsApp group link. You can join it. I will also share with the in an email. Also. Like the admin team will share with an email also. Okay. Project list document will be shared tomorrow. And what you have to do once you get the document, just give it a read. Go through the project description, what the project is, and then we will discuss tomorrow at around 6 p.m. or 7 p.m. We will discuss about it. Whatever questions that you may have, we will discuss it. Okay. Doubt clinic for project discussion. So we will have this like on 2nd November tomorrow, 6 to 7 p.m. We will have this. Tentative training schedule also I will share tomorrow. Usually, it will be every alternate day. So our doubt clinic sessions will be our training sessions also for initial projects. For advanced projects, the training will be on the weekends. Okay, on weekends, doubt clinic on every alternate day. These two sessions, job readiness workshops and job readiness, we see when we are applying to a job as a candidate, what we see, what is the process, and what should be our approach, and from recruiter side, how recruiters filter our profile, our resume, how they do it, how they reject us, how they ignore us, or how they select us. So we will look into both sides of this scenario into job readiness session, and we will also look at some resume review. So if in case you or some of you would like to share your resume to get it reviewed, so we will discuss that also. And we will have two separate, like two mentors will be there. They have good experience in the hiring, in training, learning, development. And also one mentor was part of Naukri.com. So she knows how to, how they actually work. How they kind, like we say that, okay, I applied to 100 companies, but I have not got any call. Why? That why we will try to answer in these sessions. Okay. And all sessions will be recorded, and the recording will be shared with you, but please do not skip any session, just assuming that it's being recorded, unless it's very necessary. Because see, you may have some real life, some doubts which needs to be answered instantly. Okay, so for that, please attend the sessions. Okay, Jayasri, you have just a clarification. I remember the doubt clinic timing 7 to 8 IST. Confirm it's 6 to 7 or always. Doubt clinic, okay, I believe in the form it's a 7 to 8. Okay. The 7 to 8 timing was kept earlier. However, we had some interns from New Zealand and AUS, Australia, who were not able to attend because by then it was their past midnight. So that's why we moved it to 6 p.m. What do you think, guys? Is 6 p.m. okay with you? Like 6 p.m. IST in Singapore, it will be 8:30. And those who are from Central European time, I believe it will be 2:30 p.m. for you. So does 6 p.m. work for you on weekdays? If you are available, Okay, Jayashree, you are in US, so I believe this 6 p.m. would be morning for you. So, I mean, by then, morning at around 7 a.m., 7, 7.30. So it'd be okay with you. Okay, those who have some problem, see if you can adjust it, okay? Or maybe use a recording and a huge WhatsApp group for your doubt clearance. So we will prefer, we will see if 6 p.m. can be done. Or maybe by 6:30, because actually some days I may have some sessions here. So my working hours are when I take sessions, usually it's 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. I might need a couple of minutes of rest. Okay, so either 6 p.m. or 6:30. So I will communicate this on WhatsApp also. Okay, that's all from my side. Any question? Okay, it's already 15 minutes past time. Let me take just 5 minutes to give you an insight in the project. When will seventh option be conducted? Seventh option, what you are referring to? I mean, from which slide? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Doubt clinic, you are talking about doubt clinic? Please elaborate. What do you mean by seventh? So doubt clinic will be every alternate day I mentioned, yeah? So tentatively, every alternate day, we will have a doubt clinic session. If you are available, you can attend it. Now the projects will look something similar to this. For now, we are making some changes here. Some data sets we are giving. So some projects are basically training based, and some projects are internship based. For this project number 7, 8, and 9, we are using some data sets, which actually I use in training to some of the clients here in Singapore. So it's a practical data sets. For project 9 also, it's a COVID-19 data set, which is publicly available, but in healthcare industry, it's widely used for their own application development as well. So the projects will be like this. You will have some difficulty level also, and the project title objectives will be there. What to do, what skills to use. So basically these skills are those skills which are widely used in a professional setup, professional environment. So when you join a company, you will be supposed to use conditional statements or pivot chart analysis you will do. So learn these things. These are like must learn skills. Okay, there will be some resources. So like LinkedIn Learning course is there. There are some public videos also there, and there are some private videos as well. In Power BI, this has been developed by Microsoft entirely. Okay, and it tries to teach you how to work on card usual, stacked column chart, line chart, how to create these things. What skills are there which you will use, what skills you will learn into this project. There are some optional skills also, which if you want to do, you can. Otherwise, it's okay. But at least learn these things, because these are the skills that you will use in a professional work as well. Some resources. So we have a resource from LinkedIn Learning. We have some resource from, there will be some publicly available, as well as there will be some private videos also. Similarly, for TSQL, there will be some questions that you need to answer. And now these questions are actually kind of real business questions. So when you are working on SQL, working on data manipulation, data reporting, you ask these questions to yourself to fetch data using SQL queries. So you will use that. We also provide a server that you will use. Please do not share it outside VIP program. Okay. the server credentials and what skills you are going to learn, what resources that you can refer to. So again, we have a course from LinkedIn Learning, and there are some courses, there are some videos which are again from outside. Similarly for Tableau, when we discuss about Tableau project, I will help you get this license. Those who are students, they can apply for Tableau Desktop 1 year free license. Okay, those who are not, you can use Tableau Public. The training will be on Tableau Public so that everybody is on the same page. Data will be there. This is a real-time data actually of COVID-19. And this is a bit difficult data. So we have provided a data set for beginners also. Those who are beginner on Tableau, you go with a better data, more clean data, and work on it. Adventure works. This data set is also developed by Microsoft only. Similarly for all projects, we will have some resources. I want to show something that when I talked about unlisted or videos, private videos, what I was referring to. So you see these videos, these are unlisted videos, okay? And if you search with the name, the video name, you won't be able to find. So this has been developed by Microsoft, and as a trainer partner, we are delivering it. We have the access. You cannot search the video with this name. So unlisted videos, you cannot find publicly. You can access only through the link, if link is provided to you. So please do not share it outside VIP, okay? Use it for your personal use, for your learning as a part of VIP intern, and do not share it anywhere outside. That could be a privacy violation or infringement of the privacy policy. Similarly, we have like all projects are there. So we will share this will be shared with you. You see this project number 6, I mentioned that here also we are following steps. Now, trust me, I have taken a lot of effort to prepare this well-detailed notebook. And this is actually the same thing I use in training here in Singapore, in Indonesia and Malaysia also, and to some corporate clients also. So all details are there. If you follow these things, you will be able to get intermediate level knowledge of Python into data manipulation, data analysis. There are many things out in this, and you do not need to even Google it. All explanation is there for different types of different concepts. So when you start working on it, go through it one by one, take your time. Do not try to grab everything at once, okay? If the deadline is 24th, do not try to complete all 9 projects in 1 month. Segregate what you want to do, okay? What is your career path? Data, business analysis, data science. If you want to go into data science, 1 month is not enough to learn everything. 3-4 months are not even enough to learn everything. It will take at least 1 year. You have to go. You have to go through a guided and a structured plan. Okay. So start with the easier ones. Start with the basic projects, project 1, 2, 3, like this, and then go to more advanced. And by the time you reach project 7, 8, 9, we will be in our second week of internship, and we will go through a live training on these data sets, on these skills, on these projects. Okay. So that's all about the projects. Once shared with you, read it once tomorrow, and tomorrow 6 p.m. I will take a vote in the WhatsApp group. What time is comfortable with you, because there are some more people from morning session who have joined the group. So make sure that you join the group, and in group also help others. do not send a small multiple messages. Hi, send. I have a question. Send in project number 5. Send. Do not do that. Okay. Write your detailed question in one message, because we are into different time zones. What if when you are awake, people are sleeping in some other time zone? So ask your question with complete detail in one message, and people will be able to help you out. I will take a survey later on tomorrow that when you are available for the doubt session. It will be either 6 p.m., 6:30 or 7 p.m. So I will ask this, and you can reply accordingly. Can we instead leave a voice message on WhatsApp regarding our doubts? Okay. Voice messages increases curiosity. Okay. And those who are not in, so usually when I reply to voice messages, when I have an earphone near me, if I do not have an earphone or headset, then I do not, sometimes it happens that after two, three days, I listen to voice messages. But don't worry, it's not about, it will just give one notification, right? You are writing, or if you are sending a voice message, ask your question through text in WhatsApp group so that others can also see and reply. Or you can ask in doubt clinic form. So a link will be shared for doubt clinic form, and then we can discuss it in the doubt clinic sessions also. Okay. Those who joined late. So initially we had some introduction. I see some names that were not there earlier. So initially we had some introduction, and then I believe you have catched up on other things. This session has been recorded. I will stop it now and will upload later on when the recording is processed. And if you have any question right now, you can please ask.